Okay, well, today is my first time in here in Bosco Conference. I began to be interested about presenting the Golden Visa program at the end of last year. I began to be interested in presenting this program for Russian market and for the Chinese market. So I contact one of your competitors and I organize a trip to Moscow in February, and we went to a very beautiful hotel, the Lotte Hotel of Moscow, and we made a presentation about how we work in Investor Spain, what are the services that we give. And, you know, we have some general interest, and also we saw that there were some interest from other countries like Ukraine, like Azerbaijan, like Kazakhstan. And obviously we are very interested in building a relationship with the strategic partners in these countries to offer our services. We think that this kind of business of resident by investments and investment in properties goes very much according to good alliance and good relationship and good networking. You know, as I was saying before to someone I was talking today from India, you know, that it's not like a selling shoes or like a selling a food. It, you know, this requires much better connections and much better structure. Now, how all began? You know, we are based in Malaga, in Costa del Sol, in Spain, which is one of the most beautiful and interesting places in Europe, not only to live and to enjoy life, but also to make your center of investments, your center of residence, and an excellent place for universities, and you know, and generally speaking, a quality of life for reasons that I'm going to explore later in this conference. We began like a 15 years ago as tax accountants and company accountants in our region. We were doing business locally, you know, at that time. There's a lot of work over there. And then in 2015, we began to, there were some changes in the regulation in Spain and some set of priorities for citizens that they were coming from South American countries to get the Spanish nationality. Let's say Mexico, Colombia, Panama, you know, things were much easier for them. So we began to travel to these countries to talk to people that they were eligible to get the Spanish nationality, or they were interested in investing in Spain. So we were there. We made visits to Mexico City, to Bogota, to Panama, to Buenos Aires, you know, and we managed to get a lot of people that they were interested in establishing their residence in Spain. We have to say that we do not have a program like Cyprus, for example, or like Malta or like Grenada, that you can pay big, big money and get the citizenship. What we have is some programs that the government implement a few years ago to attract investors to live in Spain. This is what we call the Golden Visa. And besides the Golden Visa, there is also what we have, the non-lucrative visa. That is a very interesting program for people that they say, you know, I like to spend something like a year in Spain. I have some money. Doesn't need to be crazy money. But let's say they want to write a book, or they just want to work in Spain, but not in the Spanish industry, not in Spain, but they want to work from Spain. So they can do that. They are basically software designers, or they are artists or there are people that just can work from any place in the world, they can come to Spain. We have the non-lucrative visa. That is a program that if you say that you have something like a 26,000 euros in a bank account that to support yourself, you can come for 1 year and get the residence in Spain, and you have to stay there, and you know, and it's very interesting. Now, the golden visa. Well, before we go to the golden visa, let's talk about something else. You know, let me see, what is this? Yeah, very good, very good. So this is the. I wanted to show you a little bit. Something about Costa del Sol. I'm sure many of you heard about Marbella, Torremolinos, Fuengirola. So this is not a normal touristic place with just a few hotels in the front line, you know. Malaga and Marbella from the 60s, from the 60s, you know, already began to develop into a first-class tourist destination. These days, we have something like a 50 nationalities of people living permanently in Marbella and in Costa del Sol. They live there. First of all, there is an excellent Mediterranean weather. Number two is a very safe destination. And number three, there are a lot of things to do there. It's not only about being in the beach and laying in a hotel and stay all day doing nothing. There is a lot of things regarding if you like yacht and you like the marinas, you like the sea sports, if you like golf. We have only in Malaga 53 in golf camps. Besides that, we have done all kind of international events, you know, in not directly in Malaga, but in the region. We have done some of the Olympic Games. We have done the Expo 92. We have done the World Cup of football and a huge number of international events. As you can see, I show you here a little map for you to see where we are. This is the regional map. And on the right side, you see where is Malaga and where are all these places, you know, all the way to Marbella and Soto Grande. And also you can see the left map that we are very, very close to every single European destination. Even from Moscow, we take you something like a 3 hours to land into Malaga. Besides that, Malaga itself has an international airport that connects to every single European destination, most of the United States destination, like New York, Miami, Washington, Texas, and of course, to a number of South American places. So when it comes to communications as well, and infrastructure, there is nothing there that we are missing. Why we went through all this process, or how we came to give all these immigration services. As I said, first we did the tax and the accounting, and then we moved into citizenship for South American people. And then they were asking, can you help me to find a property? Or I want to invest in some offices, or I want to invest in some land. Can you help me with this? Can you help me with that? So we opened a real estate unit within our company. So we help you to find a property from any type of prices, let's say for 300,000 euros, 400,000 euros, 1 million euros. So we have a nice portfolio of properties that are in the market, and so we can help you with that. So basically, we have become a one-stop shop. So you with us, you can have, we can help you to find a property, and also we can help you after that if you need it or if you want it with all the immigration and naturalization process. Okay? Now, we spend, so before, when somebody comes to us, we don't want just to say, hey, we can sell you a property, or we can sell you an immigration program. We like to understand their needs. Unfortunately, not everybody knows what they want or what they do not want. So we tell them what are the benefits and the advantage of living in Spain. We advise them to stay a little bit of time in Spain, to check around, to see how they feel about, you know, and then we present them, obviously, a number of alternatives for them to make sure that, you know, they get what they want. You know, sometimes they walk away and they say, well, this is not for me. But obviously, Spain has a lot to offer, you know, and we are there to help you with all they need in Spain. As I said, you know, we help you with the finding a property. You just give us a brief of the things you need. Maybe you need a property close to a school or close to university, or you are very much into playing golf, or you just want to be in a very quiet area, or you want to be close to a lot of shopping malls. So it's important for us to understand your needs, and we come out with a portfolio of places, and you know, we also take you around and show you whatever you need. When it comes to financing the property, obviously we can help you there, and we offer you the advice you need. At the same time, we also do banking presentations, and we tell the customer, depending of the nationality and depends of the things they want to do, what kind of mortgage can they get as a foreigner in Spain. There are differences for foreigners that are coming from the European Union, especially Germany and United Kingdom and France. They get much better conditions. When it comes to Russia or China or India, they also get mortgages, you know, but the banks obviously are a bit more demanding, you know, they don't get so much. But right now, banks are giving something like a 60% of the loan when there is a mortgage for a non-European citizen. We think that to settle down in a new country is not an easy bananas. It's more than helping you finding a property, and it's more than getting your residence card. So over the years, we have become more helpful. Obviously, this is not for free, but we think that it's very important to support customers, especially the first six months they're in Spain. They need help with in a school of language, for example, to learn Spanish. They need help, you know, sometimes with very specific accounting services, you know, like someone says, well, you know, I want to form a company here, but I want this not to be a resident company, but, you know, what do I do with my taxes here and there? There might be also that they need to import a car. You know, we can also help with the import a car. They might want to say, we want offices to rent. So there are a number of services that we are willing to provide. through us or through our good network of contacts in the region, and that makes the life of a new investor and the life of their family way much easygoing. As I said before, you know, schools and high education. I have to tell you that Spain has, and everybody knows, I mean, everybody knows that one of the best universities in the whole Europe. We in Barcelona, for example, we have the ESADE and the ICADE, that they are great schools of economics, business. In Valencia, we have the University of Technology that has sent scientifics, engineers, marine biologists to best universities in the United States. They have sent from the teachers and from the professors people to train other specialists and professionals all over Europe and in the United States. So what is also very interesting when it comes to the Spanish education system, that once you are a resident there, you pay your fees. You pay your fees in the university as a local. So education is very, very affordable. When you hear the cost a student has to pay when he goes to a university in London or a university in New York or in Toronto, they pay fees that they need to be returning for years or years to the bank. But in Spain, you can join a degree of law or a degree of physics or a degree of medicine, and you pay maybe something like a 3,000 euros per year. And as I said before, nobody doubts our education system. So what we have seen that people that are going into the residence program, they come to Spain whenever they want to come to Spain for reasons that I will explain later. This is one of the good things of the Golden Visa. And they put their children in the Golden Visa program. When the children are 18 years old, they send them to Spain, and the children have the full legal status to live in Spain, but also to pay the universities or the high school as Spanish people. And this is really, really, really good. Well, what I like of Spain as well, now I'm a bit older, you know, and I don't go out so much as I used to go, but is that there is a great nightlife in most of the cities, especially in the south, where the weather most of the year is super good with very mild temperatures and a very sunny, very, very sunny days. There are all kinds of nightclubs, discos, concerts of the top artists like Shakira and Ricky Martin and, you know, Lady Gaga. You see them in the stadiums of Malaga coming to play and to perform. So there is basically always something to do, always something to do. Eating outside, as I put there, you know, is more than a tradition. Eating outside in Spain is a kind of way of life. It's not something formal. It's not something that you need to book a restaurant, and it's not something that will cost you a fortune. So you can go out with your partner to have a meal that is in a decent place, you know. It's not a rubbish place, but you will pay for both of you something like a $35. And that's it. You will. I promise you, you will not be eating hamburgers or pizza or a sandwich. You know, you're eating a real meal. And this is one of the things I very much miss when I travel somewhere else. You know, that you want to sit in a place to eat, you really have to pay money. You pay big money. You know, but hey, what can we do? Okay. Again. A lot of food, a lot of diversity of food. The Mediterranean diet is something that that everybody knows the taste and how healthy is all the Mediterranean diet. I'm sure our friend Tassos agree completely with me, you know. Okay, and then a lot of local culture. We have festivals, not only once a year, but every single month of the year. There are festivals, there are music performances, there are shows, always things to do here and there, you know, to make it very nice to live. Okay, with this we conclude one part of this Now the golden visa. let's talk about this. I wanted one of the reasons to talk about this. Last year, Spain gave like a 1,650 golden visa permits. 17% of these permits were given to Russian citizens. The golden visa is an authorization to live in Spain on the condition that you make an investment. But the investment is for you, okay? So you don't have to make any donation to any country or to any government program. The investment is for you and it stays for you always. So the condition is that you buy a property that is more than €500,000. This property, you can buy that anywhere in the country, which is something very interesting. What we have seen in Portugal recently is that because there was so much speculation in properties in Lisbon, the government says, okay, you want the Portuguese visa program? That is fine. But you cannot buy a property in Lisbon. But this is not our case in Spain. It's a bit, you have to invest a bit more. In Portugal, you have to invest something like a €350,000. But in Spain, it's €500,000. But you can buy a property anywhere you want in Spain. It doesn't need to be one apartment of more than €500,000. You can buy two apartments or three apartments. But as long as you make an investment of €500,000 in total. Number two is that you have to buy that with your own money. You have to buy that with your money. That means that you cannot apply for a mortgage in Spain to get this type of property. But if you say, you know something, I want to buy a house of €2,000,000, fine. So I pay with my money something, let's say like a €600,000 or €700,000, and the rest, the bank finance that. The bank will do that and your application will be a process. Why? Because you made an investment of more than €500,000 from your own money. Okay? Okay, number three. It's very important that all the time that you enjoy the visa permit, you keep your property. So the government will give you every 2 years, will renew your visa, but you will have to prove that you have your property. The property, you can sell it anywhere, there is no problem, but you will not be able to renew your residence permit. One of the interesting things about the residence permit is that, in most countries, if you want to have a resident, you need to be, as the word says, a resident in the country. That means 183 days per year, But this is not the case of the golden visa. You can come even 2 days a year to Spain, you will have the residence permit to stay, you will be a resident without staying there, which is something really, really interesting. So you can just come whenever you want. Whenever you want, you have the residence, but on the conditions that you keep your property. Another interesting thing is that you can work whenever you want. You can form a company. You can open a bank account, and you can settle anywhere else you want in the country. You can bring your wife and your children with you. until the age of 21 years, you can put them in the residence program. And you don't have to pay taxes for money that you have generated outside of Spain. Okay, so once you become a full resident, you know, then you have to declare all the money that you have made outside Spain. But if you are if you have just the golden visa, you know, but you are not living in a full time in Spain, so you don't have to declare, you don't have to declare any of the incomes. So this is also very interesting in the medium term for those people that they will really like to be in Spain there. They say, some people say, you know something, I want my residence card. With this resident card, they can travel anywhere in the European Union and they can be in different parts of the European Union for something like a 90 days per semester. Okay, but this has some benefits, but there are people that they say, okay, you know, I like to live in Spain. So after 5 years, they can start the process for citizenship and naturalization. The process is, itself is some bureaucratic process. You have to show that you were really living in Spain, that you didn't have any criminal activity, that you will have to explain you were doing, but you do not have to make any big donation of money to the government. So you will only be paying some fees to process the application that are a few hundred euros, and that's it. Normally, today I had this question from someone why my application was rejected, and what I think that happens is, you know, they didn't have the accounting very, very clear. So I think I have said enough about this, about the golden visa itself of the 500 and 1,000 euros investment. There is another one. There is another one that is, as I said, is very interesting. We call it the non-lucrative visa. This program is being very attractive, especially for single people that they're on their own. They have some, obviously, some proof incomes, but not big money, something like a 26,000 euros netto per year, you know, and they can come to Spain to do whatever they want, you know, to travel, to write, to work, but not in a Spanish company. And I think this is a very good platform. For those that are thinking to explore what are they going to do in the future, or people that are still young, let's say 30 years or 35 years, they work in their countries some years and they're just looking for something new, I advise them to take this program. This will allow you time to know the country, to see how do you feel about that, you know, to make connections maybe. And then maybe you decide to form a company, or you decide at some point to ask an international company for a job position or whatever. But I think this, the non-lucrative, can be a very interesting visa for those that they have some money and want to take a year or 2 years to settle in Spain, compromise-free, you know, and to get to know the life.
Marcelo?
Yes.
Sorry for interrupting you. You started answering on the question, because people started asking, is there some additional program that we can know about? So we are hitting the topic definitely, but may I ask you, so we keep Q&A interesting and dynamic, to discuss a bit more in Q&A session about additional programs?
Yeah, well, these are basically the two programs. There is another way of getting the golden visa. That is if you put something like a one Can you say that? Can you say that? And then we explain that later.
We will explain all of that in Q&A. Is that okay? Because
exactly. So basically, I will explain about two more ways. They have not been very popular. I find them very, very elitist. You know, they have very little acceptance, but they're still there. So we will be talking about this. You know, so I talk now about the tools that are basically
the most popular ones.
98% of the applications are regarding these two that I said. Okay.
Clear. Okay. I will keep a track of where you put the comma.